So now I will start directly my lecture. Today's topic is very interesting because it is related with some basic understanding of the research, that is definition of the research as well as its connection with the Ayurveda. So I will share now my screen. So this is the PPT that I have started to explain you. I will start to explain you. This is the research question papers that I am going to start one by one. This is the part one, presented by myself, Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande. I am MD in Ayurvedic Medicine and MD in Ayurvedic Physiology. This is my WhatsApp number and this is my mail ID. So the first question is, what is research? And also there is one another part in the question, that is, describe the ancient research methods in detail and importance. But of course, today we will try to focus on this first part. And about the ancient research method, this word you can understand, this is regarding, they want to ask you the traditional methods in Ayurveda. What Ayurveda has thought about the research, that is their question. But today I'm not going to, because it is a very, very huge topic. So only we will concentrate on this research word, number one. And also I will try to tell you something about importance of research with connection to Ayurveda. Importance of research with connection to Ayurveda. Okay. There is another reference for this second part of this question. For example, here, describe ancient methods. We have to look for the chapter 5 in my book. Everybody knows that Manakarnika publication has published my research book, edited by myself and Dr. Anade, that is Deshpande and Anade are the editors. And Dr. Sachin Sarkoddar and Dr. Ila Bor, Santosh Bor, they are the authors. So we will find the answers in the chapter 5, remember, classical methods of research, or the title of the chapter is classical methods of research, but this is the same. Ancient research means the same. Try to understand these two words. Classical methods mean ancient methods. Both the words are same. Both the words are same. The question may be, classical methods of, because this is the word from the syllabus. This is the word from the syllabus. And the examination question paper setter, he has used this word, ancient research methods. So, what is actually the research? There are two subparts, re and search. So, we have to search again and again, re. It's a continuous process. Whenever we find a difficulty, whenever we find that the problem is not properly understood, we must try to find out what is the basic thing. So that is again and again searching. Searching of what? This is most important. Searching of knowledge, which you do not understand, and gaining that knowledge is also called as a research. But for example, now you are not knowing much about the research and you are attending the lectures. So whether you are doing the research? No. Gathering of information is okay. You are getting the knowledge. But the another important thing, it should not be haphazard or unorganized. We read the book, whether we are doing the research. I am attending the lectures of Professor Deshpande. Am I doing the research? No. Because there is not a systematic method of the research protocol. Research has its own methods that we are not following. That's why haphazard or unorganized gaining of knowledge is not the research. Try to understand. That means simply attending the lectures, simply reading the books, that you are getting the knowledge. But that is not a research. Then what is that? There should be some observations. This word is very important. Write down in your notebook. Observations are essential for research. Observations are essential for research. Write down these words. Very key words. I am telling you the most important word, which you have to write down in the answer book and while answering the in the Viva. Observation is a must for the research. While you are reading the book, you are not making any different observations. While hearing my lecture, you are not doing any collecting your observations. So observation is most essential part. Slide number 5. Definitions of research. First is, this is the study of any problem. So you must have some problem in your life. You must have some problem. For example, the people not getting the solution for coronavirus. What is the problem of the whole world? Whole world is suffering from corona pandemic. And what is their problem? No medicine, no medicine. Then there is a scientific and logical manner you should find out, try to find out the solution, try to find out the answer. So systematic and logical, this word is very important. Systematic and with some logic behind that. What is logic? What is logic? Cause and effect. Cause and effect. Ayurveda has mentioned Satkaryavad in Padartha Vidyan. Satkaryavad. Cause and effect relationship means logic. That I have not written here. You have to write down your notes. So, another important thing, it is systematized investigation. Systemic. You must have your question, hypothesis, aim, objectives, material, method, observation, discussion, conclusion. That is systematic. What is systematic? The question will be there. What is systematic? The steps that I have mentioned is a systematic approach to solve your problem. Systematic approach. Okay. Then, these are the different methods. What is research? To discover new facts. I have given a lot of examples here. You have to discover new facts. And then you can say, yes, I have found out this new thing in my life. Okay. Next. There is, these two words are important. One is a finding of new facts or re-establish or verify the old facts. Ayurveda is already existing. Ayurvedic principles are there. Okay. Lot of drugs are there. Arogya Vardhini is there. Yogaraj Gokul is there. Okay. So facts are there. What you have to do? Re-establish. It was 5,000 years back. Charak. No, no. Again, you prove today. Re-establish. That is most important. Hydroxyquinoline. Corona. They want to find out new molecules. New. So these are, this is new fact. Try to understand. New fact. Hydroxychloroquine molecule is a new for the coronavirus. So one is new. Yogaraj Gokul is there in line with Yogaraj Gokul. And you are re-establishing. Then. So research aims at finding out the new facts. Two things are important. This is right now. New facts. Number one. New facts. New facts. Here. Look my finger. New fact. Number two. Re-establishing old fact. Re-establishing old fact of Ayurveda. 5,000 years back. You have to prove it again. That is research. This is interesting factors that you can understood by this word research. Everything. R-E-S-E. What is re? So there must be rethinking. Whatever I am telling you, whatever the things that you are understood, you should be rethink about it. Scientists should have the brain of rethinking process about anything. Number two, he must do some experiments. Number two, experiments. So E for experiments. Sometimes research can be done by simply doing survey. You can do simple, no experiment. Only go to the 100 people, 500 people, 1000 people and take the information. Again, corona people are dying. Corona people are dying. You have to just make the survey. How many people of them have diabetes, heart problem, asthma problem, lung problem, liver problem? You are just going to the hospitals and requesting, doctor, please give me the data. Please give me the data of coronavirus patient. Whether they were healthy, whoever died, whether they were healthy or whether they had some previous illnesses. Have you done any experiment? No. You have just visited and collected the information. Visit, collect the information. That is called as a survey. Next, E for evaluation of data. Whether you do experiments or whether you do the survey, you have collected the data, and that data you have to analyze. Remember my words, analyze. So A may be for aptitude, your inclination to do the research, and I will add over here, you can also add analysis. Analysis is very important in research, analysis. This word is very important. Collected data should be analyzed. You have collected the blood. You have done the experiment of first year BMS students. Hemoglobin. Oh, 60 students, hemoglobin. And then you found out how many of them have the hemoglobin above 12 gram per cent. How many people from 8 to 12 gram per cent? How many students below 8 gram per cent? And you said it is severe anemia, below 8 gram, 8 to 12, moderate anemia, above 12, no anemia. That is your research. That is your research for first year BMS student. Because you have done experiment, you have evaluated data analysis, and then you have recognition. About that particular, your activity, you will get the acceptance from the society. Yes, I have accepted that the first year BMS student have 50% have the anemia. Then research should have the touch with current problems. Mostly they should tackle with the current problems. In this April 2020, there is a last 3 months, 6 months, we have suffering, whole world is suffering from pandemic of coronavirus. So this is current affair. Before that, whole world was worrying about the problem of heart problems. It was observed that in India, oh now, even the 30 years people are getting heart attack. So that was the current problem. Try to understand. So your research should focus on the ongoing problems in your life. And this, when you are doing the research, there should be this H. H is related with the head. You have to use your brain, logical thinking, your heart, what you know, ethical committee. What is that ethical committee? Ethical committee. Remember, REC, internal ethical committee. AEC, fourth year, don't know. Animal ethical committee. Which animals you should use for your project? Only small animals, mice, guinea pigs. You are not using dogs. You are not using peacocks. That is called emotion. In the research, there should be heart. And whatever you want to do is with, of course, your hand. Your hands will work. You can write down the material, you will collect the material, you will examine the patient. Everything you will use your power of motor system. So that is the heart. Research, you can draw this figure in your exam. This is our glass model. In the previous year, this was the watch. The sand is filled up on board and gradually it is coming down till the end of the day. So research is the same. You start with the broad spectrum thinking. Broad spectrum. What is broad spectrum? What is broad spectrum? Why there is a weakness in the students of first year? What are their problems? Is the muscle is weak? Hemoglobin is weak? What is there? What is the problem? Why they are tired? So this is a broad question. Okay? And then I have to focus first in particular problem. I must think whether there is anemia. Okay? And then I will concentrate. I will write down the whole synopsis, plan of work, aim, objective, hypothesis, etc. And I will focus on the anemia cause for the weakness. First, there is a different causes for the weakness. Now I have concentrated on the here, bottleneck, systematic, only on the anemic problem. And then in the discussion, I will discuss all the things. There are different causes. So anemia may be cause. I found that anemia was not the cause. So there may be calcium deficiency. So first, broad thinking, concentrating on one particular topic, and again discussion on the various levels. Discussion at the various, whether you consider the gender, age, then their what you can say, the lifestyle, eating habits, and you are discussing all these things in the discussion part of the research. Discussion part of the research, this is the broad thing. And then finally you draw the conclusion. First, broad thinking of the problem, concentrating on one problem, getting the observation and discussion, and finally conclusion. You understand, this is called as a research is a hourglass model. It's an imaginary, remember. It's not actually their watch like that. It's a logical thinking. Next. Research word has a parallel words, very similar words in Ayurveda. These four words you must, or five words you must remember. Anusandhana. You remember by your brain. Write down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Anusandhana, Gaveshana, Anveshana, Paryeshana, and Shodha. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At home, say 5 times this word. Anusandham, Gaveshana, Anveshana, Paryeshana, and Shodha. These are the synonyms, similar words for the modern word research. So Ayurveda has also mentioned research in its own language. In its own language, remember, German language is different, French language is different. So there may be research word translated in German, translated in France, French language, am I right? So similarly, in Marathi, what we call it is Sanshodhana. So this is the translation. But in Ayurveda, there are 4 words. Now, what is the meaning of Anusandhana? I'm sorry. Anusandhana. Anu is to follow. And Sandhana is appropriate knowledge. Sandhana is appropriate knowledge. To follow a typical method, to follow, this is something missing over here, you write down my words, to follow specific method, write down, to follow specific methods for getting appropriate knowledge. To follow specific method for getting proper knowledge. Anu means follow, and Sandhan means knowledge. Next. Now here, Gaveshana, Anveshana, and Paryeshana. Everywhere there is a word. Here you can see. Eshana. Remember this word, Eshana. Eshana means to search. Eshana means to search. Eshana. Everywhere there is Eshana. Here, to search. Can you find out this? Here, Paryeshana. Here, to search. Everywhere there is a search. Gaveshana, how that search is? With all your senses. All your Jnanendriya, Karmendriya, and Mana. All your sensory organs, motor organs, mind, intelligence, everything you are using, then only the research can be proper. So to search or to achieve the knowledge with your using all your senses, that is Gaveshana. There is a Sanskrit line also, but I think you must not remember that line. It's better to have the final outcome of that word. Anveshana, again, search. Anveshana is a desire. Anve is a word. Anu is a word, desire. Desire of searching something. You should have a strong desire in your mind. No, I will find out the problem. I will find out the solution for it. Then only the research can be made. So there should be desire. And to search from all the dimensions, pari means all the aspects, all the parameters, write down, all the variables, write down, all variables. When I want to talk hemoglobin in first year, I must consider age, I must consider gender, I must consider the food habits, I must consider the sleeping timing. So, these are all these points are called in few dimensions. There is only not one dimension, only age, no. Age, gender, diet, sleeping, stools, everything you must consider, then draw your conclusion. Then only you can have the proper research. Next. Now, this is the need of research in the field of Ayurveda. So now we will start talking about research and Ayurveda. Research and Ayurveda. In this lecture, I will try to view the most important thing, that why Ayurveda is doing, or why already there is, already research is going on. Research was there in Ayurveda. Now I am using the three words. Research was there in Ayurveda. Was, past tense. Research is there in Ayurveda, present tense. Research is there. And research will be there in Ayurveda. I have used the three tenses, past tense, present tense, future tense. It is applicable to Ayurveda and research. That means research in Ayurveda. Because many people say, is there Ayurveda has some research? You are always talking about old things, that Charak was saying, Sushrut has a dissection, Sushrut had done surgery. You don't do any research. This is the always criticism. Remember my words. Tika Marathi Madhe, criticism from the European people, from the American people. Then you must tell them, this is your misunderstanding. Research was in Ayurveda. Research is in Ayurveda. And research will be there in Ayurveda. And that's why just I was seeing the TV, and there was one news that the efforts taken by the Indian government regarding the fighting with the coronavirus is now admired by the World Health Organization. And just I was hearing about Prime Minister Mr. Modi, and he was saying that you should consider the holistic approach. He is admiring allopathy, he is admiring Ayurveda, he is admiring spirituality, he is admiring naturopathy. Everything he is respecting, but with scientific approach. So this is there. Now, what is the aim of Ayurvedic research? There are two aims. Number one, Ayurveda wants to get Brahma Vidyan. I am sorry, there are some Sanskrit or Devanagari problems while I type. I am not expert in this Marathi typing. So kindly excuse me for that matter. This word is not properly written. I know that. Brahma Vidyana. You write it properly. And what is the Brahma? Don't talk about God, etc. Don't talk about God. What is Brahma? This is ultimate truth. Ultimate truth of anything. That is your research final conclusion. That whatever you research do and you make a conclusion, that conclusion should be such a conclusion, it's final. It's final, it's ultimate, that everybody in the world will follow that. So, now what is the whole world is searching for? To get the vaccine, to get the vaccine for coronavirus. That is the Brahma Vidyan, absolute truth. So, even Ayurvedic drug should be searched in that way, that whatever I claim, it should be final. It should be accepted to everybody. It should be accepted for all the time. That is called the ultimate, last truth. No challenge. That's why this is the first, our aim, Brahma Vidya. And second, desire for better standard living. Because we people are want to live happily, healthily, and long life. Not only long life, remember my words. We are interested in happy and healthy life. And to make our happy and healthy life, we are trying to find out different things. We are finding, and we will continue to find. Why we are searching? For better and happy life. So that is another our desire. Ashana means desire. Next. What are our objectives? Why we are doing the research? First objective, that is maintenance of the health and treatment of the disease. Dhatu samyak kriya chukta. Tantrasyasta prayojana. Ayurveda has already given. Prayojana means its objective. That Ayurveda wants to treat the patient very properly. Will you please close your mics? Just a moment, I will check whose mic is on. Please check your mics, huh? It should be off. Okay. So here you can see. Second, my objective is I want to understand if there is any unwanted phenomenon, unwanted, untoward phenomenon. For example, when I'm doing the vamana, I want to know what are the complications of vamana. Then I mean that previous scientist had made already the work for that, and they have written that these are the complications of vamana, that is vamana vyapak. How they have found out? Only after the research, only after making the observations. So that was their aim, to find out any complications or unwanted effect. Next, why we are doing the research in Ayurveda? Third one, to understand useful things in our life. To understand useful thing in our life, we want to do the research. For example, we have already a lot information about rasayana. And what is rasayana? Yat jara vyadhi vinashana. Whatever the things that will remove our jara, means old age, and vyadhi means diseases. We want to find out the different medicines, different plants, different herbs, different lifestyle, which can, of course, you can understand that jara and the old age cannot be stopped. But remember my word, you can delay the process of aging. You can delay. For example, if I am getting all my senses are weak at the age of 60, I can take something, chyavanprash, or making my lifestyle perfect, so that aging will be delayed. I will not be old. I will not, my senses will be old till the age of 80. So that is called as an anti-aging management. This is new word for the first year, fourth year. Anti-aging. The research is done for anti-aging management. Next, we want to investigate the principles of Ayurveda and try to find out practical application. You have learned all the Sharira Kriya Siddhanta in first year BMS. You remember all Siddhantas. Number one Siddhanta was Loka Purusha Samya Siddhanta, Pancha Bhautik Siddhanta, Dosha Dhatu Malamula Mishriram, Samanya Vishesha Siddhanta. Different principles are there. One of the principles in the fourth year BMS is a Darshana Sparshana Pariksha. These are the three ways to examine any patient. This has been already there. But now, this is the basic principle. We know there is a limitation to my eyes. There is a limitation to my eyes. So, I must use the technology which is available. The name of the technology is esophagogastroduodenoscopy. Here, esophago, then stomach, and then duodenum. I have to examine by scopy. I cannot examine by my eyes, scopy. Okay? And that scopy can give the help for diagnosing the Parinama Shula in Ayurveda. Parinama Shula can be compared with duodenal ulcer. Parinama Shula can be compared with duodenal ulcer. So in spite of doing only Darshana Sparshana Pariksha, I am using the principle with the help of modern gadgets. With the help of modern gadgets. Now, another example. Sparshana. Previously, the temperature was here. Look here on the screen. Just like touching your hand, touching it, temperature. But now we have the thermometer. So to prove our principle, we can use the modern gadgets, modern instruments. Instruments means gadget. This is English word, gadget. Next. Slide number 14. Importance of Ayurvedic research, objectives of the Ayurvedic research. For example, I want to prove Ayurvedic principle from modern point of view. There are modern doctors, MD, MS doctors are there. Many of them don't believe on Ayurveda. And I say, no, my statement is correct. For example, one statement is Vata Drute Nasti Ruja. Especially neurological problem. If I have the sciatic pain, nerve pain is there due to the prolapsed disc, lumbago, and cervical spondylosis, I am having the pain on the hand. And I say this is a problem of conduction. This is a problem of Vata Dosha according to Ayurveda. Modern doctor will say, this is your principle. Let me check it. Then there is a nerve conduction study. Nerve conduction study. So then when I do that, then he will agree, okay, this is Vata Dosha according to Ayurveda. When I do the nerve conduction study, then this my principle of Ayurveda will be accepted. That is the importance of research. Then I always say, for many diseases, Sroto Sangha, obstruction in the srotas is the cause. Why the patient has got Rudraoga, heart problem? Because of the Sroto Sangha. Then I can ask 2D echo or angiography and I can show them, yes, my clinical diagnosis was correct. I was thinking that there must be any problem in the srotas, microchannels. This was my Ayurvedic diagnosis, Sroto Sangha. And then I show him the picture. See, this is our parallelogram. Sroto Sangha, here is the blockage in the artery, coronary artery. So that you have to prove our statements to the modern world. These are the principles of Ayurveda. And I am looking towards it. Can you see here? From modern point of view. That is called as a need of time. Write down this word. Need of the time. 21st century. Modern scientists, they are demanding. Don't only use your Ayurvedic language. Prove it. Then you have to do this all thing. Then. Importance of Ayurvedic research. Another reason. To elaborate and explain Ayurvedic principles. For to make Ayurveda as a global science. Global. Worldwide. So there is one example, modification of lifestyle as per Prakruti. If you advise the person that at what time he should get up, what type of the water, temperature of the water he should use for the bath, which occupation he should do, what time he should eat, what he should eat, at what time he should go to the bed, all these things I can explain when I know his Prakriti. I always ask the patient of Vata Kapha Prakriti in foreign countries. I made my practice in foreign countries 20 years. Remember my words. 1993 to 2014. So why? Because these people are very attracted to my principles. I advise Vata Kapha people. Vata Kapha both have the cold, Shita Guna Samai, cold property. So I advise them, if you remain in the air condition, your asthma will not be cured. They follow my advice for 1 year. They drink all the time warm water. They avoid the freeze thing. They avoid the freeze material. And they come in the next year and say, Doctor, fantastic, you are God. I say, why? No, last year you remember you advised me that I have the Vata Kapha Prakriti, I should avoid the cold thing. Doctor, I am get benefited. And that's why now Ayurveda is popular in the Europe, in the America, because of global. Why this is global sense? Because of the principles that we are applying while treating the patients. One of the principles is Prakriti Pariksha. Next, to study the cause and effect relationship, we must do the research. Ayurveda is doing the research. Ayurveda has done the research. For what? Karya Karana Sambandha. Karyakaran, cause and effect relationship. Cause and effect relationship. For example, we are saying dadhi, curd, yogurt is a kapha prakopak. This is our siddhant, okay, kapha prakop. Then I must make the survey. Again, survey. What I will do? Habit of eating curd every day. We have to find out. You have to ask the person, are you eating curd? Go for 100 patients, 500 patients. Curd is a fermented product and you find out whether these patients are suffering from sinusitis, kaphaja vikara, kaphaja vyadhi. diseases because of the cough, sinusitis, and vasomotor rhinitis. Whole the year, 12 months, the patient has a running nose. Patient has a running nose. Anti-allergic drugs are given.